Hey everyone, my name is Edward and I'm a technical marketing engineer here at NVIDIA. Today, I'll be walking you through the Build a RAG Agent coding workshop. So without further ado, let's get started. This is the launchable page for the Build a RAG Agent workshop. You can see I've already started the launchable, the instance has been provisioned and is running, the VM's been built, and the setup scripts have already completed. From here, I can go ahead and click Open Notebook, and this will launch a JupyterLab environment for me to work in. From here, we can see a few different things, namely under the NVIDIA DevX Learning Path section, we can see a few different tiles. The first is an Introduction to Agents workshop. This is the first workshop in this series. And then next to it is this Agentic RAG workshop, which is the workshop that we'll be focused on today. So let's go ahead and click into that. And that should open up a new page for us. So basically in this workshop, you'll get a better understanding of what traditional RAG is, as well as what agentic RAG is. And then you'll be able to create your own IT help desk agent. And you'll see how agentic reasoning and agentic tool calling can come together with your RAG systems to help improve the quality of your generated responses. Without further ado, let's go ahead and get started. Let's start with some foundational concepts. Just to recap, traditional LLM inference is when a user provides a prompt, feeds it through an LLM, and gets back a response. Oftentimes, the responses can be good, but there may be times where the responses can be of poor quality as well, such as hallucinations or just a response that's too general. And this is really where traditional RAG comes in, right? So if we store all of our data, our documents, our context into a vector database, and every time a user submits a query, we can query that database for the most relevant information, feed it into the LLM as additional context to use, we can get out a response that's much more grounded to the contents in the database, which can help greatly improve response quality. But you might run into issues with this as well. So, for example, if a query, isn't relevant to the information in the documents in the database, if you have poor quality data in the database, that might affect the quality of your response as well. And so these problems we try to solve with agentic RAG. This is where agents can come in, use reasoning and tool calling, and retrieve from different sources and help improve the response quality even further. So we're going to talk a lot about React agents today, basically combining reasoning with action. So React agents can reason upon a particular query, particular action or a state, and call to different tools to go out to different data sources and continually iterate on this process to make sure that the response that we get out is of the highest quality. Cool. And so this is the architecture that we're going to be focused on today with our agentic RAG system. We're going to have documents in a database and a React agent to help query that database to get out responses in an IT help desk use case. Cool. So let's go ahead and let's build one. The code that we'll be using today is primarily contained within this ragagent.py file, which we'll get to in a little bit. But for now, focusing on the instructions, you'll see that they provide basically step-by-step tasks for you to accomplish to help build out your final RAG agent. So you can see, for example, different agent configuration and setup steps that you should take, how to create the vector database to use as part of your RAG system. And there are different exercises built into this ragagent.py file that are left to the user, where you can go through and implement certain things, and you can come back to the lab instructions here to check your answer. So all you have to do is, for example, expand this accordion, and you'll see what the correct answer looks like, compare it to what you wrote, and be able to slowly build up that understanding. So for building up this RAG agent, we'll first need to create the vector database, split the documents into chunks, which you'll help implement. And you're going to need to embed those chunks into vector representations, which you'll help implement as well. And from there, once you have those vectors, you'll just need to ingest those vectors into a vector database. And then that completes the ingestion stage. From here on out, we need to define what the retrieval stage looks like. So here we're going to build up slowly our retrieval chain. So we're going to start with a simple retrieval where you have a database and you have your embedding model, and you're able to use that to retrieve different documents. But you can also make it more complex, augment it as well with a re-ranking model. So basically a re-ranking model takes out the retrieved documents and then basically orders them by relevancy, where the most relevant ones are re-ranked to the top and the less relevant documents are re-ranked to the bottom. And you can help implement that as part of your agent as well. From here, we built out the retrieval chain, which looks something like this. And then we're ready to create the actual agent itself once we have these components ready. And so the brains for our agent is going to be powered by the actual LLM model. So we're going to go through and implement that to help power up our agents. And we need to give our agent some instructions. So we also define a system prompt here that you can take a look at. And then since we're using LangGraph as the agent framework, we're going to need to build out a LangGraph graph, basically a flowchart that helps connect all these different components that we've defined together. So you can see, you know, we've defined our LLM, our retrieval chain, our system prompt, and we're going to bring all those together to create this LangGraph graph, which is basically what our agent is going to do, a flowchart of what our agent is going to do. And so you're going to help implement that as well. And then finally, once you're done, your agent is ready for showtime. And so let's take a look at the actual code itself. You can see that I've already implemented all the sections from the instructions. And you can see that all the components here are pretty familiar if you read through the instructions. So there's going to be, you know, a data loader. You're going to need to split that data into different chunks, and then embed those chunks, and then finally ingest those into the vector database. And then we can define a re-ranker as well to use for the retrieval stage. And so that goes into this retrieval chain that we built out. For the agent itself, we're going to need a model to be the brains of the agent. So we define an LLM for that, and we feed it a system prompt. And then we can sort of combine all these components that we've defined together into this final agent object here. And so we finally created our React agent. And at this stage, you should be good to go. So let's go ahead and move on to the next step, which is actually running our agent. All right, so this section will walk us through step-by-step on how to actually deploy the agent that we just built. So let's go ahead and click Next. We can see that we need to start up the server. So this server will help us host our agent behind an API. That way, as a user, I can interact with, you know, a client interface and then be able to interact with my agent programmatically. So let's go ahead and see how to do that. Clicking Next, we see that we'll need to open up a terminal window. And from here, we'll need a few commands. So let's go ahead and cd in the code. And then finally, LangGraph dev. And this should kickstart that process of spinning up that backend server for our agent. Moving on, we see we can, you know, examine the log outputs. If there are certain errors, we can see what that looks like. Fortunately for us, it looks like our server should be up and running. So let's go ahead and move on. Great, so from here we can chat with our agents. So provided as part of this workshop is this simple Streamlit app that's sort of a client interface for you to interact with your agent. So let's go ahead and open that up and see what that looks like. And then from here we can enter a query. So you can imagine for an IT help desk use case, you know, one example query you might see is, you know, how do I reset my password? So let's go ahead and ask this question to our IT help desk agent, and let's see how it responds. Great, so a few things to note here. We see that there's agentic reasoning components that we can expand, so we can see into the agent's actual, you know, thinking process. For example, you know, here's what the agent, you know, here's what the agent thought of my initial query, and then, you know, it decided to go ahead and choose to, you know, call a tool. And so in this case, it called out to this particular tool, which is, you know, going into the knowledge base. And you can see how agentic reasoning combined with agentic tool calling can get out some very relevant information for our agent to return to the user. So we can see the reasoning process. We can see, you know, the tool call out to this, you know, particular IT help desk knowledge base that comes up with this exact procedure. And then since, you know, the model that we're using is a Nemotron Nano V2 reasoning model, we can further do some reasoning upon, you know, the retrieved information and be able to get out a much more comprehensive and much more specific answer. So you can see what the reasoning process looks like here, as well as the final answer. So you can see the final answer is specific, it's relevant, it answers a question, and overall it's just a much higher quality response than if you were to ask a vanilla, you know, standard LLM, or even if you were to ask just a traditional non-reasoning, non-agentic RAG system. So you can see, you know, the high quality of responses that you get. Great. So from here, we can move on. This section is sort of optional. It just deals with agent observability. So if we've configured the Langsmith API key, what we can do is we can look at the different response traces on the Langsmith website for this particular run. So you can see all the different metrics, the traces, things like that, which could be helpful for your development. Cool. That about wraps it up. You're able to build a RAG agent as well as interact with that RAG agent and see the quality of responses that you get out from that RAG agent. By completing this workshop, hopefully you're able to get a better understanding of what Agentic RAG actually is, as well as hands-on experience with adding agentic tool calling and reasoning to your traditional RAG systems. Thank you so much for joining us today. We'll see you next time.